Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome back. Hope you're having a fantastic day. Okay, we have to show it here. One of the first players to three mark his new Snap Snap tank. Right, the new Snap Snap double-barreled Russian TD thing. Look at that. Two marks on his barrel right now. This is the three mark game we're going to watch. And what is his name? It's a long name. Quinton is Ringman. Quinton is Ringman. In his ISU 1222, soon to be followed by the introduction of the ISU 1223, which will have three guns. This guy will succeed in, it will display six marks on his barrel, which is the equivalent of two when you have one barrel. And he just moves up here, ready to snap someone. If anyone, if they spot anyone, well, he... I see. And what, is he going to snap? Nope, he's a single snapper. You know what he did there? He was so far back that GSOR was outside the white circle. You see the white circle on the map? The GSOR was outside the white. If you rewind that, you'll see that the GSOR was spotted and was on the map, but outside the white circle. Which means it doesn't render on his screen, but he knew he was there, so he just lined it up. He you see it on the minimap, you can line up the direction of your gun with the enemy, and he just blind shot him. And what he's doing, because this thing does not have very good armor, is he is a blind snap. He's sustained stealth, and now he wishes he didn't do the double snap, because he could have snap this guy, so he only gets a single snap. And funny, he got some spotting assist on the T-54. He spotted, let's just stop here. Come on, look where the T-54 is on the minimap. Look where he is. He's not far from him, and there was a direct line of sight between them at one point, because he got 407 and 81 spotting assist on a T-54, which is a Tier 9 medium tank, and he has remained undetected. And if he spotted the T-54, there were no bushes in between him and the T-54. Does that make any sense that he didn't get detected? Okay, whatever, let's just snap him. There you go. Snap. Now that time he was sitting in the bush, which was smart. I don't know how he spotted the T-54 and did not get spotted in return. The T-54 is very damaged now. Why? Because he spotted him. So I don't think the T-54 had a dead loader or a dead whatever. Maybe the T-54 has a 50% crew, but snap him. I have no idea how that happened. I think the first damage the T-54 took in the game was due to his spotting. So he was, the game just started. I don't think he had dead crew members or module damage, which could make his view range smaller, right? So now these guys know that their teammates just died. Right there. My T-54 teammate just died in this position. So it's a good idea for us to follow in that position. That's always a really good strategy when you're playing World of Tanks, guys. Is to know, well, there's a dead teammate. He died right here. So I'll just go right beside him. And I'll just wait here. And he wants to double tap. Oh, he took this guy out. He took out the Miel, which is a Burask. And did his sixth sense go off there? I'm going to watch that again, because I'm doing commentary and I don't follow what the hell's going on. Okay, look, he comes up here. He's going to... That guy's a blind shot, I assume. Okay, he shot this guy. At no time did his sixth sense go. Okay, we're going to rewind it even further, because I don't know what's going on. Wargaming, your game doesn't make sense. The spotting, I was just talking about... We're going to rewind it even farther and watch this whole thing again. Okay? There. Okay, let's assume now he's stealth now, right? He's stealth. So let's watch this, because I don't know how he spotted the T-54 and remained invisible. He's an invisible tank now, Wargaming? Okay, so let's watch. He is not spotted now, right? It's been long enough. Let's see if his sixth sense goes off. He's not spotted. He's holding a shot. He's going to double tap. Boom. His sixth sense went off. He was spotted by the Miel. Okay, sixth sense is off. He's spotted. He's probably still lit. He's still lit. The tiger shot him. He's still lit. 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 And now he backs up. Is he stealth now? Or is he still lit? Let's see. The tiger shot, he's probably still lit. Now he's been lit the whole time. The Miel must have had, what's that skill that keeps you lit for an extra 3 seconds? Now he should be stealth now, but we don't know. He could still be lit. Perhaps this bush he was lit the whole time, I guess. He's lit the whole time, but nobody shot him. So it's not a question of view range, it's a question of utterly clueless, hapless, pathetic, useless enemies. I guess that's what it is. It's not the game mechanic where you get off easy this time, Wargaming. It's not your programming. It's the clueless morons that play the game. Look, the Three Stooges and the Tiger. Four of them. I guess this is one of the recipes on how to three-mark your tank, right? Is just to have a total incompetent collection of clueless idiots playing this game. I'm going to repeat that strategy. For those of you who did not follow, just keep this in mind. When you're playing the game, keep this in mind, okay? Are you ready? When you notice that one of your teammates just pokes on a ridgeline and explodes and dies, when you see that, the best strategy for you is then to say, oh, look, my teammate just went up that hill, and as soon as he poked that ridgeline, he died. I think I'll do that now. Right? And then you poke the ridgeline, and you get shot. And you go, oh, let me do that again. And then you should have at least 4 or 5 members of your team repeat that over and over until they're all dead. That's a great strategy. Like, how else are you supposed to do commentary when the opposition is a collection of morons? Am I supposed to say, oh, and he's aiming now, he's pre-aimed and using the concealment provided by this bush, and oh, look at the gun depression. Perhaps if he dabs the 2-key, he will load a shell with higher shell velocity and be able to take him out on the battlefield faster. Oh, the gentleman is having a miraculous turn of events which allows him to sneak up behind this tank and auto-aim. And, oh, as he's unaware, he will ignore him and just let his teammate have the kill for free. Am I supposed to do fucking commentary like that? It's just a fucking load of horse shit is what it is. It's a shit show. Right, let's see. Let's watch. Double tap. Boom. Auto lock, snap, snap. GSOR, hello, McFly. Hello, did you forget that there's a big fucking TD behind you? McFly, hello, McFly. What's going on? Look at these enemies. What are they even doing?
Well, it's very simple, Mr. Kellerman. This particular player spent some money to get this tank, this new tank that we've provided in-game. So we are giving him a matchmaking versus program bots, which will allow him to get his 3 marks. He will be a happy customer, and he will spend more money soon.
What the fuck? Let the tiger mouse kill you now. No, the tiger mouse is just watching. He's just a spectator. The tiger mouse isn't really playing. Does this make any sense? Guys, does this make... The tiger mouse is looking the other way now. Ooh. I keep getting shot. Like, guys, how did he do that? He's working on his third mark. How did he get a game like that? 8,410 damage, 8 kills. Well done. Well done. Right. We have to congratulate him. He deserves it. You spent the money. You supported Wargaming, and you are rewarded with three little, actually six marks on your two barrels. So it's beyond me how that happened. It's just, you know, guys, shit happens, I guess, right? Like a lucky choice lucky that he got the opponents that he did. Do you get enemies like that? How many of you are watching that going, I don't get enemies like that. I'm usually on the team that just got smoked. But anyways, that when I rewound that video a couple of times, because I was just could believe what was going on, and I missed the fact that I think he was lit the whole time when I thought, well, is Sixth Sense not going off? So it's a good thing we did that. Which, I mean, just illustrated that there were four idiots on the enemy team that just kept pushing forward and getting shot. Pushing, like, it's bad enough pushing forward like Muppets, but pushing into a TD that has two guns. And this guy is just going for it. Holy shit. Look at this. They killed your driver. He's just angled and going. He said, I'm not waiting back. Look at the position this guy took. Okay, we're going to enjoy this game. But just as a little aside, when you're playing the game, right, if you were that guy and you're playing the game, one little trick that you can use to know whether there's a mod you can download that counts off whether you've gone stealth or not. Whatever. But one of the tricks you can use is when he backed up there behind the ridgeline in the bush, if he was the only guy spotting those tanks, what you can do is you can just wait until they disappear. It doesn't work if your teammates are spotting them, right? I don't remember whether his teammates were also spotting them. And this guy's just, what a position he's taken. Oh, and his engine's knocked out. Oh! So if you're in a position where you're doing the spotting and you back up and then the enemies disappear, then if they've disappeared, then probably you've disappeared. Unless one of them has that that skill that's called what's the one that keeps them lit for another 3 seconds? What's it called, guys? I can't remember. The skill, what is it called? I mentioned it already. Everything being equal, if the enemies disappear, it means it's been 10 seconds. And then that means you've probably disappeared from their screen. Then you go back in your bush. And this poor Tiger P is having trouble. He had the right idea. He flanked. He really hurt this guy, but he's just... this position is allowing... Whoa! They killed our driver, but you ammo racked them. So that's the trick. Just back up, wait till the enemies disappear, and then if they've disappeared, you've probably disappeared. Wait another 3 seconds if you want to be sure. Right? And here comes another one. Because that's what you want to do. Let's do it here. My teammate just exploded right here. So I think the right thing for me to do is to go exactly where he was. He almost succeeded. The guy's of 16 HP. Now this bold move has just stopped the enemies. This was a brilliant, very aggressive move. I hope his teammates appreciate the sacrifice he's made. He's given up all his HP and he's basically just stopped the enemies. Because this is the one position that the enemies, if they move up to right around where his Tiger P and Black Prince are, would be very difficult to fight them. And now his teammates are finally putting on their big boy pants and moving forward. There they come. The Black Prince is gonna put up a crossfire now. Oh, he could die here, it would still be an amazing... oh, he bounced! It would be an amazing game, even if... Look at that. He's getting all the... He caused that guy to overcommit. And his J Panther and Tiger P are providing support fire. This is beautiful. I'm still in awe of that game, guys. 8 kills, 8,000 damage. Like, what kind of collection of enemies was that? How does that... I guess I know how it happens. It just, you know, shit happens. But, man, do you get enemies like that? When you're trying to three-mark a tank. He's on his two marks. And he's trying to do it. He's one of the first guys to do it. He play, and he just got rewarded by the matchmaker of just get the clueless clowns. Where are the clowns? This guy. Okay, he's got to fight a tiger one. If you suck, he's going to bounce. He's going to try and bait the shot and let the tiger one bait the shot. Oh, no, he doesn't have. Jesus Christ. Unbelievable, eh, guys? Just unbelievable. Way to go, Jay Panther. Like I said, shit happens. He types in chat, idiot. The guy's side scraping out to shoot. Woo, just, imagine if that was like a real military. You got your cannons ready to shoot the enemy. You put your head in front of it. And it looks like they're just going to cap for victory. Oh well, a little bit of anticlimactic ending here. But this guy deserves to finish on top because he led his team to victory. It was a brilliant move. He aces the tank, which is good to see. Way to go, 0-0 noob. That was not a noob move. That was a brilliant, aggressive move at the beginning. It was only 5,000 damage. It wasn't like a stellar, super, you know, over-the-top game. But that aggressive move at the beginning basically stopped the enemies in their tracks. And he single-handedly stopped that flank. He single-handedly stopped half the enemy team from doing anything. So, and look at how much he bounced. What's his total? He bounced 4,110 damage with his armor. So just a fantastic game. We ended on a fantastic, well-fought game with an aggressive play compared to the shit show first game, which resulted in 3 marks. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to the channel if you're enjoying the content, and I will catch you on the next one.